As we gather to celebrate the Feast of Pentecost, we are reminded of the beginnings of the Church, a Church wherever we are called to be as God's people, baptized and confirmed through the Spirit. We in particular remember today all of our confirmandi to be, soon we hope to share in their joy-filled day as they receive God's Spirit at confirmation. But we also are recalling our own willingness to allow Christ to reign in our hearts and in our lives. And so we ask the same Spirit to renew us once again in our vows of baptism and to always send us forth as witnesses of our faith. And so now we ask the Lord's presence in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us ask God's pardon and peace and for the strength of the Spirit to continue to renew us and send us forth in God's name.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, send the Spirit upon us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and one day bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Bless you.
Let us pray. O God, who by the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of believers. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus, and Asia, Phrygia, and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs. Yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different works, but the same God who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and all were given to drink of one Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
First day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, this week we could have a real long homily because it's the birthday of the church and I have to cover a lot of territory, almost 2,000 plus years. But of course, you know me, I always spare the congregation, whether we're in church or we're at home. But you can get your coffee if you need to in the meantime. There's a beautiful image that I always remember, or more importantly, an experience that we can all have if we go down by the waterfront when it's very windy. And whether it be taking a walk along the water or maybe around some part of the port of Buffalo, we know that on a very, very windy day, it can be difficult even to walk against the wind. And today we can think of the wind of the Holy Spirit in the images that the scriptures give us of the wind and the fire. But in particular with the wind on the shore of the sea or the lake, I often watch the seagulls. I mean, I can watch them around here if you've got a nice big garbage dumpster and they get in here on a real windy day. But for the most part, if you're at the waterfront, they don't seem to have to even move their wings at all. If they get into a great force of wind, it just takes them away. Wherever direction they choose to go, they just move a little bit. I thought of that when we think of the image of Pentecost. This week I've been praying, well, even more than a week, praying that the Holy Spirit, come Holy Spirit, come into my heart. Come Holy Spirit, come into the lives of your people. And we know the Holy Spirit comes to us as we sometimes even beg the Spirit to come and be with us in all of our needs and what we are about as we do the work of God. Think of that seagull. Think of us. We're going against, at times, the wind because we're trying to get somewhere. Or we're trying to move in the spiritual sense to where we would like to be. Think of the seagull being taken by the wind. Let's the wind take them. Think of God coming, the Spirit coming into our lives. Come, Holy Spirit, take us where you want us to be rather than where we want to be. And we know it is that driving force that continues to give us that life in God. Wind, life-giving, the air we breathe, the wind, the column of destruction and death with hurricanes and tornadoes. Fire gives us warmth and heat and protection, cooks our food, or it can rage and engulf and burn and consume whatever in its path. Wind and fire. Our first reading today, the Holy Spirit comes like a driving wind, not to destroy the place where the disciples and Mary were gathered, but to fill it once again with the presence of God. The Spirit comes as tongues of fire to settle on those early believers, like the disciples and Mary. They aren't burned or even singed, but they're given now rather hearts inflamed with the gifts of the Spirit. And how about us? When was the last time the wind of God's Spirit, or the breath of His Spirit, or the fire even speak to us? Even a whisper of the Holy Spirit moves in your heart, in your mind, in your thoughts, in the very consciences of our lives, or the very recesses of our hearts, we say, urging us to respond, to speak, to move, to do, to act, or perhaps urging us to sit still and keep our mouths shut. God's presence burning within us. To choose wisely, to decide prudently, to act justly, to do the right thing. Particular gifts that we hear that are given to the church, as St. Paul says to the Corinthian community, brothers and sisters, to each individual the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. The gifts particular to yourselves, talents, skills, abilities, haven't we seen those these days? On the internet, on the television, new creative gifts that people didn't even realize they had. Crazy, some, yes, some to build up others in the lives of God and caring and the concern through the gifts now used, never before touched. Gifts yet unwrapped. Do you have any? Gifts undiscovered. Can you discover them? Gifts unused. Can we use them? To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. Yes, for us as individuals, as a people of God, and for our church, and for the care and concern of others. And so we come to Pentecost once again, the Spirit which we've already received at baptism, but yet calling us with, yes, the wind, or maybe the fire, the wind leading us and pushing us to where we haven't been in God's way, or the fire burning away, consuming those things that hinder us and keep us from allowing the Spirit of God to act within us. And so we pray, come Holy Spirit, once more lift my heart with the fire and power of your gifts. Come Holy Spirit, light the way. Help me to see and embrace all that God is revealing. Come Holy Spirit, fill up wisdom's lamp to enlighten my mind, my thoughts, and my will. Come Holy Spirit, with the knowledge and truth, brand my mind and my heart with the word of the Lord. Come Holy Spirit, be my beacon of counsel for judgments both prudent and pure. Come Holy Spirit, and kindle my courage to do what is right, to do what is fair, to do what is just. Come Holy Spirit, and stroke my desire to humble myself before God, doing His will. Come, Holy Spirit, light the flame of your presence and draw me to reverence and prayer. Come, Holy Spirit, flood my heart with your gifts and my soul with the breath of your peace. Come, Holy Spirit, to the Father's love draw me through my Savior, my Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, renew the face of the earth. As God's people, we now renew our faith as we proclaim. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As true disciples of faith, we too await once again to be renewed in the Spirit as the Lord breathes his life within us. And so now we ask the Lord to hear the prayers that we offer in faith for our church, for those who have asked our prayers, and for ourselves.
May our country, our world, and our church grow in unity through the sharing of the gifts and respecting of diversity. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who continue to suffer due to the coronavirus pandemic, for them and all who are working to alleviate their suffering, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For decision makers at all levels, that they may serve their communities with wisdom and good counsel, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a decision on who will be the next Bishop of Buffalo, for a faith-filled leader who will shepherd the diocese with compassion and love, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to war, hatred, terrorism, and greed, for lasting peace, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, for those who have died, Loretta Zaibala, Frank Zappora, John Jumper Jr., that our prayers accompany them in life and death, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own special needs and intentions, and for the intentions in our parish prayer basket, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear the prayers of your people as we look to you this day. United in Jesus and strengthened in that spirit, we turn to you, who are Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice, and graciously lead us into all truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land and every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us,
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all of our bishops and clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her spouse, Blessed Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We pray our spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you had already come and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain in all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Since we'll be ending our May during the week, we'd like to give honor to the Blessed Mother, her month in May. In particular, at the end of our celebration, we'll pray the litany to the Blessed Mother, so you can join us a little later if you'd like. Also, to just recall the strength of the Spirit upon the apostles and Mary at that first Pentecost, that during these days we can soon allow our own hearts and lives to rejoin in our facilities here in church. And so we're working on our guidelines that the diocese has presented to us. And so as soon as we have a little more information, we'll provide that for you in the bulletin and, of course, on our website. So thank you for joining us once again. And we ask the Lord's blessing to come upon us all during this week and to give us joy in our hearts. And if you haven't yet said, pray, come Holy Spirit during this week and allow the Spirit to guide you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, the Father of lights, who was pleased to enlighten the disciples' minds by the outpouring of the Spirit, the Paraclete, grant you gladness by his blessing, and make you always abound with the gifts of the same Spirit.
Amen.
May the wondrous flame that appeared above the disciples powerfully cleanse your hearts from every evil, and pervade them with its purifying light.
Amen.
And may God, who has been pleased to unite many tongues in the profession of one faith, give you perseverance in that same faith. And by believing, may you journey from hope to clear vision.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.